Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends. Today we are going to start with insertion of an elements into the array. Now what does the insertion means? Insertion means adding of new element into the array. Now this element can be added start of the array, end of the array, or it can be added in the middle of the array or whichever position you like within the array. So the insertion means simply we need to add new element into the array. Insertion. As defined, insertion is adding new element into the array. For this to do, we need to define the class and its object. I have defined a class named as insert array. In that, I have used three integer variables named as n, position, and x. As you may be aware, x defines the size of an array. So I have used the n as size of array. Next, I have used the variable called as pos, which defines the position at which I am going to insert the value. And x is what we are going to use for entering the element value. Then we are going to use scanner class object to get the values. So I have defined a scanner class object called as s. Inside that we are going to store the value. To take the value from the user, first I need to define the size of an array. Now this size is to be taken from the user. So to do this, we need to give the message to the user that he needs to enter the size of an array. To do this, I need to write down the statement system.out.println enter number of elements you want in array. This is what we are going to use the size of an array. So to do this, I'm going to use the scanner class object s. So the statement becomes n equal to s dot next int. Using scanner class object s, I'm going to take the number of elements which user wants in the array and store them into n. So n is going to use as the size of an array. Next, I've defined an array called as a. Now in this case, I'm going to add the size of an array to the elements. What does it mean is that whichever size is given by the user, that is number of elements, in that I'm going to add plus 1. Now why do I need to make plus 1? Because my array index will be starting from 0. So I need to write down the statement int a square brackets new int n plus 1. Let's take example, the user wants 3 elements. So they enter the number of elements you want in the array is going to be 3. Now the value of n is going to be 3. So for user convenience, I'm going to add the size of array. So I write down a new int n plus 1. So size of a becomes n plus 1, which is 3 plus 1. So size of a becomes 4. Now we need to have the elements. For this, I need to take the elements from the user. So I write down the statement system.out.println enter all the elements. So user starts entering the element. Now to take the values into the array, I need to use the again the concepts of for loop. As you may be aware, for loop format is initialization, condition, and then increment or decrement. For this, what I have done, for int I equal to 0, I less than size of the number of element. In this case, I store the element size in n. That's why I am writing I less than n. Okay, now let's take example, n value is 3. So I become 0, 0 less than 3, true. So I go inside the for loop. Now my value of index is what? 0. A of 0 is going to be s dot next in. So the value coming will be taken from the element from the user. That will be stored at index number 0. A0 would be storing the first element of the array. Like this, second element, third element, fourth element. And when the condition becomes false, and when does the condition become false? When we reach the last element. As soon as we reach the last element, then the size of I will be incremented. Now size of I is incremented, that won't be less than n, it will be equal to n. So what happens, that condition of for loop which we have written I less than n, that becomes false. So for loop is not now executed. We have already done with the entering of all the elements into the array. Now the array elements are entered, so this for loop won't be executed since I is now equal to n and is not less than n. Then we need to ask the user at which position he needs to insert the element. For this, we need to give the message to the user that which element, at which insertion point you want the insertion of the element. For this, we are going to again give the message to the user using the line system.out.print. Enter the position where you want to insert the element. This line indicates that user will enter the value at position which he chooses to enter the element in the array. For this, I have used the variable POS, that is position variable, to take the position of the element at which user wants it to be entered. For this, what I need to do, POS equal to s.nextInt. Once the user enters the value, that value will be stored in POS, which is position at which the user wants element to be inserted. Then, once we have done with the position of the element which the user wants to enter, then we go for asking the user to enter the exact element value. So to do this, we need to give the message to the user that please enter the value. To do that, we write down the statement system.out.println, enter the element you want to insert. Using this line, we pass a message to the user that he needs to give the value of element to insert. That will be stored in variable named as x. So the line becomes x equal to s.nextInt. So the whichever value is entered by the user is stored at index, so it's stored as variable x. Now let's revise the whole thing. We have used three variables, n, pos and x. N is going to define the number of elements which are going to use in the array. Pos is the position at which we are going to use the enter the value, and x is what, exact value of the element which we want to insert. To do this, we have used n equal to s.nextInt to get the number of elements, a square bracket I equal to s.nextInt to get the elements, and to have the position I have used pos equal to s.nextInt, and to have the insert element I have used x equal to s.nextInt. Now friends, we have done with the value insertion from the user to the particular variable only. Now I need to insert that particular variable value into the array named as into the array. For this, again we are going to use the for loop. How do we write down the position now? Now we write down for int I equal to n is the size of array we want. So my position will be from the last element. That's why I write down for int I equal to n minus 1. N is what, my size of the, that is number of elements we want in the array. Out of that last element we are going to start with. So I have written for int I equal to n minus 1. Let's take example, my n value is 3. So for int I equal to 3 minus 1. So the value of I is be now 2, which is the last element. So remember friends, we are going to start with the last element. As you may be aware, we have used three variables n, pos, x.
n is going to give me number of element. POC is going to give me the position at which I need to insert the element. And x is going to give me that particular element. Now to do this, we need to use the concepts of for loop. For int I equal to n minus 1. Now why did I take n minus 1? Because I want a value of n to be starting from the last element. So to have the value starting from the last element, how do I write int I equal to n minus 1? Let's take example, I need to have a n number of elements 3. So the last element will be stored at n minus 1. So the value becomes for int I equal to n. Now in this case it is 3. 3 minus 1, which is 2. For I int equal to 2, next statement will be I should be greater than position minus 1. Why did I take position minus 1? Because in case of array, always index starts with 0. So the position which user enters, let's say example, user enter 2. So in this case, he is entering the user as value as 2. But in case of array, it will be stored at 1. That's why I've written I greater than equal to position minus 1. This for loop will execute till I get that particular position. Once I get that particular position, this for loop won't execute. So once again, how do I do? For int I equal to last element, that is n minus 1, till I will go till I is equal to position minus 1, or it is greater than position minus 1. The position which is there is through the user input. So I is greater than equal to position minus 1. Let's take condition where it is true. So that will be executed. Now once this is executed, for loop is true, I need to make some transformation of the values. Now the value is stored using the index number. My value index is I, index subscript is I. So my value needs to be transferred. How do I make the transformation? Is through this one. AI will be transformed to AI plus 1 position, because I want new element to be inserted. So index number 0 value will be transferred to index number 0 plus 1, which is A of 1. 1 will be transferred to 2. Like this, we are going to transfer the value. Okay, friends. Now, once this condition is false, which condition? That is, I is not less than position or is not equal to position minus 1. That condition is false, so the value we are not going to execute. Now, once we have got the position stored, now we need to just make the transformation. How to make the transformation? Is through this one, A position minus 1. Now value is stored in x variable which we user want to enter, so x will be transferred to position minus 1. So let's take example, user giving the position as 3, so it will be stored in index number 3 minus 1, in this case 2. So let's take example where x value is 10. I need to store in position number 3 as per the user, but in case of array, it will be stored position minus 1. For that, it will be A position minus 1. That value, x value, will be transferred to the position minus 1 index number. Now we are done with the values. So after this, we need to start displaying the values. For this, a proper message needs to be given to the user. For this, we need to write down System.out.println, write down the statement after inserting. So after inserting the values, we need to write down. First we have used the values before, and now we are writing the after inserting. This is for int I equal to 0, I value should be less than n, I plus plus. When this is done, I have written the values, condition is true, that will be executed. So we write down System.out.println. Now the value is stored in the index value. So it is index subscript, which is very important. We need to write down System.out.print AI. First time it is going to be 0. So index number 0 value will be printed. Next 1 will be printed. This will go on till we have value less than n. That will be the value. And once this is done, we need to write down statement what variable values are stored. For that, we are writing system.out.print a of n, where n is what? Number of elements you want in the array.
Thank you friends for watching this video. Please subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press the bell icon.